Hello students, welcome to IAS by Heart. Finally, the UPSC announced the new date for prelims as well as mains exams. The prelims exam which will be held on October 4, 2020 and the mains exam which will be held on January 8, 2021. So from June to October, we will have around 100 and plus days. So we will utilize these 100 days very effectively. Our academy, IAS by Heart, will bring a new plan, a comprehensive plan for 100 days. Let me see the plan one by one. So we have 100 days plan. To split 100 days into two parts, the first 50 days for your UPSC mains preparation and next 50 days for your UPSC prelims preparation. So, in first 50 days, you are going to prepare for UPSC mains exam, right? So, the study plan is you have to spend 8 hours of time per day, and this plan goes up to 31st of July, and within that time, you have to cover almost 70% of your UPSC main syllabus, right? So, there will be a split for 8 hours. So, first 3 hours, you are going to spend for your optional preparation. In optional, especially for the paper 2. See, why it is paper 2? Actually, in every optional, the paper 2 will having more amount of syllabus from GS. So, this will be useful for your prelims as well as mains exam preparation, right? And next 1 hour for your essay. See, in essay preparation, you have to prepare around 10 to 15 themes. Essay on women empowerment, essay on Indian education system, essay on India's health system, and essays which are related to Gandhian codes and etc. Okay, and next 3 hours of time you are going to prepare for GS papers. See, in GS papers, you are going to make notes for core topics of mains like world history. And then society part, in paper 2 governance and social justice part, in paper 3 especially for disaster management, and then internal security, and paper 4 ethics, right? And final thing is you have to spend 1 hour of time for your answer writing practices. See, this is very important. In answer writing practice, you can improve your confidence in mains exam as well as it will create a good marks for your final ranking list, right? Then if you have good understanding, good confidence with respect to the mains exam preparation, you have to write one essay in every weekend, and you can take test GS or optional for every 15 days once. Okay, actually this will be a comprehensive plan. Okay, we'll go into the next. Next, actually this study plan for the aspirants who are having less confidence about the prelims 2020. So here's the study plan. So you have to spend 9 hours a day. So in 9 hours, for mains you have to spend 3 hours and prelims 6 hours. Okay, so this plan goes up to 31st of July, and in that time you maybe cover 30% of your main syllabus. Okay, so this is the split. So you can spend 1 hour of time for the optional GS paper and answer writing practices too, and remaining 6 hours of time you spend for the prelims only. In prelims examination, so you read all GS subject and revise those subject and take as much possible of test from the subject. So this is will create a confidence in both prelims as well as mains examination, right? So next 50 days, actually this plan will common for all the aspirants who are preparing for the coming prelims examination. Okay, the study plan is, so from August 1st, 2020, you must start your UPSC prelims preparation, right? So from August to October, we'll have around 60 days of time, which is very important for your prelims. Then in each day, you have to spend 10 hours of time for your prelims preparation. And then third important thing is, in GS subject, we have a variety of material. So, but you can stick, you can limit your books for very limited. Example, for polity, it is only Lakshmikant. For economics, our class notes and then budget economic survey. For environment, only one book. For history, only one book. So this is the important, this is very important for your limiting of books, which will be useful for your efficient time or effective time utilization, right? And then to revise all GS subject. See, revision is very important. Once you read all GS subject, the revision, you can go up to 2 or 3 times revision, right? And next one is at least 2 subject per day. Yes, actually, if you have take 1 subject per day, it will create a boring in your preparation. So you have to very diversified. So then only your preparation is more effective. So you may take at least 2 subject per day. The subject combination is polity, economics, and then geography, environment, or geography, history. So these are all the subject which is very relevant. You can interlink the 2 subjects, right? And then most important thing is, you have to give more importance to the current affairs, because more than 40% of questions from current affairs only. Okay, so in current affairs, you have to read from June 19, 2019 to June 2020, right? And then you can take as much of possible full mock test, not subject wise test, full mock test, right? This is very important. You have to take around 10 tests, right? That will be improve your confidence into the prelims exams, right? And then you can spend 1 hour of time for the CSAT exams also, but it is not mandatory. If you have very confident about CSAT examination, you no need to spend for 1 hour per day. But before the prelims exam, you have to, before in the sense 15 days before the prelims exam, you have to practice the CSAT in aptitude and as well as reading comprehensions, etc. And final thing is the practice. So you can take more test for your preparation, then only it will create the confidence into your prelims examination. Okay, so you please to take more test, right? So I hope you all are understand the 100 days plan of our academy. So please use these 100 days very effectively for your both mains as well as prelims preparation. All the best for your preparation. Thank you. Have a nice day.